He says, "My dear friends, I am so sorry that I'm unable to be here tonight. Each concert we do is a unique journey, and the music we share together is the culmination of many hours of musical soul searching. You can imagine how disappointing it is for me that I'm not here with you. However, I'm happy that Zach and my dear friend, Danny, have helped to make this night joyful. I want to thank my colleagues for their support and the school for making sure that my students have this experience. Finally, as you are listening to the music tonight, none of it would be possible without the inspiring and wildly creative students on stage. All praises. Much love, enjoy the concert, and I will see you in January. Carl." So, if you'd like to take a wave upstairs, we miss you, and we'll dedicate this concert to you. I hope you all enjoy. I'm going to pass it over to Zach and the orchestra.
All right, good evening, everyone. Welcome. Thank you so much for coming. I'm Zach Zeitlin, as Danny just mentioned. That first piece many of you might have recognized is a theme from the television show Game of Thrones, wonderfully played by this orchestra. And before I hand the mic over to a student who's going to introduce our next piece, I just wanted to thank you all for giving me the opportunity to be of service and try to help out in this concert, and for the opportunity to work with these amazing young people who've been so brave and flexible in working through this difficult situation without a teacher whom they obviously love and look up to and who has inspired them so much and prepared them well for this concert. We could not have done it without the support of lots of other faculty members and staff, Michelle Zuckman, Hillary, Keith Weiss, Beth Johnson, Galen Winden, Alexa Quinn, and probably other people I'm forgetting, but it was a real team effort to get this concert to keep it on the calendar. So without further ado, who's going to involve me? Abby? Abby will introduce our next piece.
Hi, guys. So for those who don't know me, I'm Abby, and I'm a junior. And I've been in this orchestra with Mr. Bradley since sixth grade. And every year, I'm in awe of some of our incredible musicians who are here. And I myself am not nearly the most talented one here. I haven't had a formal violin lesson since eighth grade. But orchestra is always my favorite part of the day because I get to spend it with a group of people who are so passionate about what they do. And this piece that we're about to play really gets to highlight some of our most amazing players. And every time we play it, I just love listening to my peers. And putting this together has been anything but easy. We've never done a piece quite like this, and it's produced quite a bit of stress between us, but I can't wait to let you all hear what we put together. So please enjoy Concerto Grosso by Antonio Vivaldi.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. My name is Ming-Yu Zhou. I'm a senior at Friends Central. And the next piece that we're going to play is called The Skater's Waltz. And the writer's name, I'm not sure the pronunciation, is Emile Waterfall. And it is composed in 1882, and it is inspired by the skater's beautiful and elegant movements. And it's a very classical and beautiful piece. We really enjoyed playing it. We definitely faced some obstacles, but gradually during the rehearsals, these great musicians actually work together and we go through it. And I really hope that you can enjoy listening to this piece as well. Thank you.
Thank you.
Jazz band, but we have one more piece left, and Lindsay will be in the honors band.
Hello, my name is Lindsay Schweitzer. I'm a junior, and the last piece we'll be playing tonight is a compilation of songs from West Side Story. The West Side Story was composed by Leonard Bernstein, and one of the main reasons why we're playing him is because this year marks the 100th year anniversary of his birth. Leonard Bernstein was not only a really influential composer, but he was an American Jew living in the time of the Holocaust. And he believed that our reply to violence would to make music more intensely, more beautifully, and more devotedly than ever before. I hope you hear that when we play his music tonight.
Thank you.
Yeah, welcome again. So I've had the pleasure to work with the jazz band for the past 2 weeks, and there's incredible leadership in this group. So I'm gonna pass it off to Nina Salzman, Senior, to introduce the group.
And I just want to address really quickly how weird it feels to be doing this without Mr. Bradley. He is, in many ways, the heart and soul of this whole band. He has taught me personally so much about what passion is and what it means to love what you do. And it's been incredibly inspiring and the reason that I play an instrument. So we're really sad that he can't be here and Mr. Bradley on the live stream. We are gonna show you how much we want you to feel better with our playing. Hopefully we're gonna put all of our get well wishes into that. And hopefully you guys enjoy that.
Thank you, Nina. Thank you, Nina. So for this first song, we have a special guest. Miss Beth Johnson is back on campus as upper school principal, and she'll be joining us for this first song.
Respect just a bit. Hello. I'm Benny. Our next song is a little ditty called Sand Dude by a guy named Clifford Brown. And so every year in jazz band, every season in jazz band, we kind of have a song where we just go down the line and all improvise over the form. And this is that song. And Mr. Bradley would always say it's kind of the band introducing themselves to the audience. And I think that's a really cool way to think about it. So like, here's us.
Thank you. Hi, everyone. I'm Gavin. Nice to meet you. So that song was sent to you. So it's by Max Roach and Clifford Brown, off of one of the greatest jazz albums of all time, Studying Brown. And every time I hear that song, I'm happy, like automatically. Like, I feel like that's the type of song that you would play at a wedding or something. Like, it's just, every time you hear it, just that melody right when it comes in, it's just really energetic and it has an incredible feeling that it emits while I'm listening to it. Yeah, so I'm gonna hand the mic over to Nina.
So the next piece is called Blue and Green by a very famous man named Miles Davis. And this piece is a very unique piece for a very unique band, in my mind. I have heard that the way it's written is like musically genius, but I wouldn't know because I don't understand it at all. And Mr. Bradley tried to explain it like 6 times to us, and I got a little bit from that. So I'll tell you what I got, which is, in most music, for those of you who don't know, the way the chords work is that they're cyclical. So like there's one beginning chord, and then all of the other chords lead you back to that beginning chord, and it takes you home. And that makes music satisfying to our ears, and it's what we feel comfortable hearing. And if you don't hear it, it feels weird. And in this piece, you don't hear it. So most songs, here's my analogy. Most songs are like a roller coaster. That's a little cliche, but like there are like ups and downs and turns, and some parts are high and some parts are low. But if most songs are a roller coaster, this song is like an infinite hill, and you just keep going and going. Maybe one of you out there can catch it.
Thank you.
Camila, I'm a senior. So for me, blue is the color of sadness and gray is the color of hope. And blue and gray reminds me the life itself. So the life is always hopeful if we never give up. But life does not go always go in the way that we want. So the troubles and interruptions we encounter are the blueness in green. And as a senior, we are hearing back from colleges, and most of us are hearing back this evening. And I just want to say that for those of who haven't gone to colleges yet, don't give up. Like, life is always hopeful, and we need to move forward. Thank you.
I'm very moved right now. I'm certainly feeling all the healing vibes. This is incredible. I feel very blessed just to be on stage with this group of musicians. The next song is Red Clay, which is a really funky song. Freddie Hubbard wrote it, and it's called, this style of music is called hard bop, which mixes bebop and funk and R&B. And this group is about to get down. Thank you.
Sounding this great at first, but the way I try to see it is that us pulling it together and putting the effort in is sort of a testament to how much being here and playing this music matters, and sort of showing that we really cherish this gift that Mr. Bradley gives us by letting us play and letting us express ourselves beyond just doing it. And I think that's really important. So for our final piece, I'm going to hand my mic over to my good friend Evan to introduce Wings.
Hey, y'all. My name's Evan. Nice to see everybody here tonight. I'm a junior here at FCS. And pat yourselves on the back. You made it. It's the last piece. Let's get a round of applause. Thanks again, everybody, for coming out tonight. And I'm going to introduce our last piece, which is called Lincoln. Vegas. If you were here a couple years ago, you might recognize it because we in fact played it a couple years ago at one of our spring concerts. And we loved it so much, we just wanted to do it again. And it's gonna sound a lot different this time if you remember that spring concert, because we had just like an amazing influx of new musicians, of people coming up through the middle school and finally getting here and getting to the upper school jazz band. And they sound like we have our own unique sound every single year based on the people who come in. And I'm really excited to play this song again. And I know it's some people's first time playing this, and I'm really happy for them because it's an awesome song, and we hope you enjoy it as much as we enjoy playing it. Thank you. Thank you.
We hope you feel better. Thank you, everybody, for coming.
Can everyone give Danny another round of applause? She's been great.
Thank you so much for listening.